Our bait of choice today for targeting these big reds, we're using a blabbermouth popping cork. And as you can see, it's got a lot of noise and rattles. It moves a lot of water. It kind of imitates another fish hitting the water, and it just gives them something to focus in, and they'll find your trailer bait here, which is running about 2.5 feet below it. This is a DOA bait. It's got a Z-Man hook in it, 1/4 ounce. When you get back on this cork and pop it pretty good, what's happening is you're popping the cork this way, and this bait is down on the bottom, and when you pop it, it comes up. And this tail will start flapping as it's falling back down. And when it's falling back down, most of the time, that's when you get your bite. And he's seeing it flutter down like something's hit it and injured it, and it's just going down to the bottom, and that's when he picks it up and runs. We're using a light action rod. It's a 7/8, 7/10. Got a medium-sized reel on it. That happens to be a Pen 4000 Fierce 2. It's probably got 250 yards of 40-pound braid on it. And that's enough of backbone to get the hook into that fish. You really kind of let the fish just do his own thing. I mean, when he hits it, you just kind of hold on to it, the braid, and the 50-pound fluorocarbon, that'll stick the hook in him pretty good. You don't have to do a lot of jerking and snatching. I've learned just to let them run with it. It's the best way to catch them, so you get more hookups and put more fish in the boat. On a blind cast, your bait in the water is better than hanging out in the boat. So you need to be fishing no matter what you're seeing. There's a few bait balls out here probably 100 yards out, and we're gonna work our way over to them. Your chances of hooking up are a lot better when you get around the bait. Now this isn't something that's easy. I mean, it will wear you down. I mean, but the reward is big. That's the thing behind it. Because, I mean, sometimes it's not a numbers game. I mean, of course you'd like to catch several, but if you go out and caught 2 or 3 apiece, you've had a great day. So you got to work for them and just hope, you're being put on fish in an area that's been a lot of fish. And that's what my job is.